based on the theory that was postulated by Karl Marx, we can see that the world has further been divided into the superstructure and the substructure. The superstructure and the substructure. The superstructure are the advanced countries. And the substructures are the developing countries. Now, if you look at it critically, we will discover that there is a trade imbalance between the two of them. And apart from that, we also discovered that the concept of Karl Marx, which was saying that was based on historical materialism, which was, talking about the creation of a classless society or elimination of a conflict, or disagreement through the creation of a classless society has become a utopia. Now, what we're saying there is that the creation of a classless society as postulated by Karl Marx is no longer possible or tenable. And because of that, there is a trade imbalance between the superstructure and the substructure. And there's also a high level of exploitative tendencies between them through the multinational companies and the multinational corporations that are operating in the substructure. And apart from that, the substructure has become a dumping ground. The substructure cannot measure up technologically and in terms of market-wise in international system. And because of that, they have become a dumping site. And because of that also, there are also often what we call raw materials that are bought by these superstructures at a very cheap price. And it is being sold to them back at a very, very high price. So the trade imbalance is always is going to be there. So what we're saying there, that the historical materialism or the dialectical materialism, which we're talking about, which is the contradiction of the social forces. So when you hear the word contradiction of the social forces, or the negation of the negation, you are still talking about the same thing. You are talking about a negation of the negation, contradiction of the social forces. You are still talking about what we call a dialectical materialism. So the dialectical materialism here is the human value as postulated by Karl Marx. So if you are talking about a dialectical materialism, you are talking about the human value that was postulated by Karl Marx, which is an economic value, as opposed to the material value that was postulated by Friedrich Engels. And don't forget that when Friedrich Engels was talking about dialectics, he was referring to the relationship among nations. But when Karl Marx was referring to dialectics, he was talking about the class struggle, the classes in the society, the class struggle between the have and the have not. And it's making us understand that the reason why man is impoverished or poor is because of the exploitative tendencies of who? Of the bourgeoisie. So he's saying here is that the bourgeoisie is responsible for the poverty, for the starvation wage that is being paid to the laborers. Why? Because of the surplus value. The surplus value goes to the bourgeoisie. Why? It pays the proletariat a little amount of money. So there's a kind of an imbalance there. So the bourgeoisie is gaining more and the proletariat is gaining less. That is what it's saying. So the dialectical materialism, as we're talking about, as postulated by Friedrich Engels, he was referring to spirits, that when nation attains perfection, they will get to a period where they will get to the spirit, which is the highest level, which was what he was talking about here. But to Karl Marx, what he's saying here is that the highest level of dialectical materialism is when a classless society is being established. But unfortunately, a classless society is not possible. Because why? Because of the owing factors which we have stated so far, so forth. So we can now see that the epoch of human development started from the communal level, primitive communal system, the era of slavery, the feudalistic period, and the capitalist period, and the period that Habermas was talking about, where there's going to be an overthrow of the so-called superstructure or the bourgeoisie, which will now lead to what we call socialism. But fortunately, a classless society is an utopian society. And that is where the concept or the theory of Habermas has been contradicted, that has not been able to establish a classless society. Because most of the empires or most of these countries that were formerly practicing socialism, like Russia, Russia was disintegrated by December 25, 1991 was the period of the disintegration of what? Of the Soviet Union. So before, we used to have what we call the Union of the Soviet Socialist Republic. Now we have what we call the Federation of what? Of Russia. So Russia was an empire at that time, but now that empire has what? Has been disintegrated. So even the so-called Chinese that are practicing socialism before, every one of them is moving to what we call the capitalism now. So the era of what? Of a classless society or establishing a classless society is becoming a mirage on daily basis. So the relationship between the superstructure, like we said before, is an unequal relationship, which is based on what? On exploitative tendencies, and which is based on what? On financial oligarchy. And what do we mean by financial oligarchy? We're still talking about what we call imperialism. So on this note, we're going to stop today on what we call dialectical materialism. Until we meet next time, stay blessed and what? And God bless every one of you. Always go to our station on YouTube, on David Oni, subscribe to this channel, and always leave your comments so that we can serve you better. Till we meet next time again, thank you and God bless. Bye-bye.